Hi everybody and welcome back to another vlog. Today, of course, I'm back in Venice, but this time I brought a friend.
Am I coming in?
Come on, darling. Welcome.
Hi.
This is Priscilla.
Nice to meet you.
From Melbourne. And today we're actually going to do my Venetian food tour because food, Venice, everybody loves food.
So excited.
So we're here in the quarter of Dorso d'Oro and we're going to our favorite, well, my favorite, which I hope will be your favorite too, pastry shop. So we'll take you along and I think it's going to be a really good day and hopefully you guys enjoy it and get some good tips of where to eat in Venice. So let's go. So we're here at the Citadina Fornolo. Yes, there you go. Specifically for their cakes and their cute coffees. And we both ordered profiterole. So mine is like a custom one, and Priscilla has tiramisu. So now we're eating. So we arrived here a bit late today. Ideally, it's best to come in the morning and you can still get a brioche or a croissant or cornetto, as we call them here in Italy. But the little cakes as a treat for midday are still phenomenal. I think, anyway. You're gonna have the calories, make them good calories.
Healthy breakfast, all the carbs, for a day of walking.
Get the carbs in. So, another tip about coffee culture in Italy is it's not really appropriate to drink a cappuccino or a latte, say, after 10 a.m. So now the time is 12:15 and so we're having espresso coffees, no milk, but there's plenty of other carbs and milk in what we just ate anyway. Okay, so next we're going to Osteria, which is on the edge of a small canal across from where the gondoliers prepare the gondolas. And we're going to have crostini, which are these little slices of toast with amazing different toppings. And of course we're going to have an Aperol Spritz because it's mid, well, I don't have a watch, but it's midday and it's time for a drink. So that's where we're going next. Okay, so we're here at Osteria Pasquero. We've got our crostini, so prosciutto di Milone, salmon, ricotta, and some sardines, and of course, the Aperol Spritz. And we're going to sit this and watch the gondoliers. Priscilla, stop two of our tour, and what do you think so far?
I am in love.
In love?
Absolute love.
Yay. So good. I could feel it in my bones. There was something going on,
that shade of doubt. In London, drunk. Night in the Olympic.
How excited are you?
I'm so keen.
She knows me in and out, love of a different kind, but we still have no control. Cause when the daylight comes, we're just good friends.
So we're running because it's about to melt. And so that was Suso, craziness, but glorious. They have amazing coats, as you can see. Now we're going to do the token Venetian tourist shot of get a photo on a bridge before it melts. Possibly. We're trying.
If we make it.
Here we go, here we go.
Not so good for words, that's why we don't get that far. But she still reads my mind, so we can follow through. Always let our bodies talk. Cause when the day I comes, we're just good.
Noticed so far from watching my vlogs, but this city is phenomenal, and so because of that I wanted to do Venice food tours because I'm obsessed with food and I'm obsessed with the city. And so Priscilla's actually my test bunny, and you can even book a tour with me if you think this is fun by clicking in the link in my profile. But now I want to grab some postcards to put up at my desk so I can be inspired even when I'm inside the house. I can't even believe that I live in this city, like honestly, it's insane. So to answer questions, yes, you can drink the water from the springs in Venice. Let's taste it. You're fine.
You'll wave the feet, my life.